Asparagales. Asparagales, asparagoid lilies, is an order of plants in modern classification systems such as the Angiosperm phylogeny group, APG, and the Angiosperm phylogeny web. The order takes its name from the type family Asparagaceae and is placed in the monocots amongst the lilioid monocots. The order has only recently been recognized in classification systems. It was first put forward by Huber in 1977 and later taken up in the Dahlgren system of 1985 and then the APG in 1998, 2003 and 2009. Before this, many of its families were assigned to the old order Liliales, a very large order containing almost all monocots with colorful tepals and lacking starch in their endosperm. DNA sequence analysis indicated that many of the taxa previously included in Liliales should actually be redistributed over three orders, Liliales, Asparagales, and Dioscoreales. The boundaries of the Asparagales and of its families have undergone a series of changes in recent years. Future research may lead to further changes and ultimately greater stability. In the APG circumscription, Asparagales is the largest order of monocots with 14 families, 1,122 genera, and about 36,000 species. The order is clearly circumscribed on the basis of molecular phylogenetics, but is difficult to define morphologically, since its members are structurally diverse. Most species of Asparagales are herbaceous perennials, although some are climbers and some are tree-like. The order also contains many geophytes, bulbs, corms and various kinds of tuber. According to telomere sequence, at least two evolutionary switch points happen within the order. Basal sequence is formed by tick-like in majority of higher plants. Basal motif was changed to vertebrate-like tick and finally the most divergent motif tank appears in Allium. One of the defining characteristics, synapomorphies, of the order is the presence of phytomelanin, a black pigment present in the seed coat, creating a dark crust. Phytomelanin is found in most families of the Asparagales, although not in Orchidaceae, thought to be a sister to the rest of the group. The leaves of almost all species form a tight rosette, either at the base of the plant or at the end of the stem, but occasionally along the stem. The flowers are not particularly distinctive, being lily type, with six tepals and up to six stamina. The order is thought to have first diverged from other related monocots some 120 to 130 million years ago, early in the Cretaceous period. Although given the difficulty in classifying families involved, estimates are likely to be uncertain. From an economic point of view, the order Asparagales is second in importance within the monocots to the order poles, which includes grasses and cereals. Species are used as food and flavorings, for example onion, garlic, leek, asparagus, vanilla, as cut flowers, for example freesia, gladiolus, iris, orchids, and as garden ornamentals, for example daylilies, lily of the valley, agapanthus. Thus although most species in the order are herbaceous, some no more than 15 centimeters high, there are a number of climbers, for example, some species of asparagus, as well as several genera forming trees, for example agave, cordylini, yucca, dracaena, aloe, which can exceed 10 meters in height. Succulent genera occur in several families, for example aloe. Almost all species have a tight cluster of leaves, a rosette, either at the base of the plant or at the end of a more or less woody stem as with yucca. In some cases the leaves are produced along the stem. The flowers are in the main not particularly distinctive, being of a general lily type, with six tepals, either free or fused from the base and up to six stamina. They are frequently clustered at the end of the plant stem. The Asparagales are generally distinguished from the Liliales by the lack of markings on the tepals, the presence of septal nectaries in the ovaries, rather than the bases of the tepals or stamen filaments, and the presence of secondary growth. They are generally geophytes, but with linear leaves, and a lack of fine reticular venation. The seeds characteristically have the external epidermis either obliterated, in most species bearing fleshy fruit, or if present, have a layer of black carbonaceous phytomelanin in species with dry fruits, nuts. The inner part of the seed coat is generally collapsed, in contrast to Liliales whose seeds have a well-developed outer epidermis, lack phytomelanin, and usually display a cellular inner layer. The orders which have been separated from the old Liliales are difficult to characterize. No single morphological character appears to be diagnostic of the order Asparagales. As circumscribed within the Angiosperm phylogeny group system, Asparagales is the largest order within the Monocotyledons, with 14 families, 1,122 genera and about 25,000 to 42,000 species, thus accounting for about 50% of all monocots and 10-15% of the flowering plants, angiosperms. The attribution of botanical authority for the name Asparagales belongs to Johann Heinrich Friedrich Linck, 1767-1851, who coined the word asparagini in 1829 for a higher-order taxon that included asparagus, although Adanson and Jussieu had also done so earlier, see history. Earlier circumscriptions of Asparagales attributed the name to Bromhead, 1838, who had been the first to use the term Asparagales. The type genus, Asparagus, from which the name of the order is derived, was described by Carl Linnaeus in 1753, with 10 species. He placed Asparagus within the Hexandria monogenia, 6 stamens, 1 carpel, in his sexual classification in the species Plantarum. The majority of taxa now considered to constitute Asparagales have historically been placed within the very large and diverse family, Liliaceae. The Liliaceae family was first described by Michel Adanson in 1763, and in his taxonomic scheme he created 8 sections within it, including the Asparagi with Asparagus and 3 other genera. The system of organizing genera into families is generally credited to Antoine Laurent de Jussieu, who formally described both the Liliaceae and the type family of Asparagales, the Asparagaceae, as Lilia and Asparagi, respectively, in 1789. Jussieu established the hierarchical system of taxonomy, phylogeny, placing Asparagus and related genera within a division of monocotyledons, a class, 3, of Stamina Paragynia and order Asparagi, divided into 3 subfamilies. The use of the term ordo, order, at that time was closer to what we now understand as family, rather than order. In creating his scheme he used a modified form of Linnaeus' sexual classification, but using the respective topography of stamens to carpels rather than just their numbers. While de Jussieu's Stamina Paragynia also included a number of orders that would eventually form families within the Asparagales, such as the Asphodelae, Asphodelaceae, Narcissae, Amaryllidaceae, and Irides, Iridaceae, the remainder are now allocated to other orders. Jussieu's Asparagi soon came to be referred to as Asparagaceae in the French literature, Latin, Asparagaceae. Meanwhile, the Narcissi had been renamed as the Amaryllides, Amaryllidae, in 1805, by Jean-Henri Jalmassant-Hilaire, using Amaryllis as the type species rather than Narcissus, and thus has the authority attribution for Amaryllidaceae. In 1810 Brown proposed that a subgroup of Liliaceae be distinguished on the basis of the position of the ovaries and be referred to as Amaryllidae, and in 1813 de Candolle described Liliaceae Jussieu and Amaryllides Brown as 2 quite separate families. The literature on the organization of genera into families and higher ranks became available in the English language with Samuel Frederick Gray's The Natural Arrangement of British Plants, 1821. Gray used a combination of Linnaeus' sexual classification and Jussieu's natural classification to group together a number of families having in common 6 equal stamens, a single style and a perianth that was simple and petaloid, but did not use formal names for these higher ranks. Within the grouping he separated families by the characteristics of their fruit and seed. He treated groups of genera with these characteristics as separate families, such as Amaryllidae, Liliaceae, Asphodelaceae, and Asparagaceae. The circumscription of Asparagales has been a source of difficulty for many botanists from the time of John Lindley, 1846, the other important British taxonomist of the early 19th century. In his first taxonomic work, An Introduction to the Natural System of Botany, 1830, he partly followed Jussieu by describing a subclass he called endogeny, or monocotyledonous plants, preserving de Candolle's endogeny Phanerogame, divided into 2 tribes, the Petaloidea and Glumaceae. He divided the former, often referred to as petaloid monocots, into 32 orders, including the Liliaceae, defined narrowly, but also most of the families considered to make up the Asparagales today, including the Amaryllidae. By 1846, in his final scheme Lindley had greatly expanded and refined the treatment of the monocots, introducing both an intermediate ranking, alliances, and tribes within orders, i.e. families. Lindley placed the Liliaceae within the Liliales, but saw it as a paraphyletic, catch-all, family, being all Liliales not included in the other orders, but hoped that the future would reveal some characteristic that would group them better. The order Liliales was very large and had become a use to include almost all monocotyledons with colorful tepals and without starch in their endosperm, the lilioid monocots. The Liliales was difficult to divide into families because morphological characters were not present in patterns that clearly demarcated groups. This kept the Liliaceae separate from the Amaryllidaceae, Narcissales. Of these, Liliaceae was divided into 11 tribes, with 133 genera, and Amaryllidaceae into 4 tribes, with 68 genera, yet both contained many genera that would eventually segregate to each other's contemporary orders, Liliales and Aspergales respectively. The Liliaceae would be reduced to a small core represented by the Tulipae tribe, while large groups such as Ciliae and Asparagi would become part of Aspergales either as part of the Amaryllidaceae or as separate families. While at the Amaryllidaceae, the Agaviae would be part of Asparagaceae, but the Alstroemerae would become a family within the Liliales. The number of known genera and species continued to grow, and by the time of the next major British classification, that of Bentham and Hooker in 1883, published in Latin, several of Lindley's other families had been absorbed into the Liliaceae. They use the term series to indicate superfamilial rank, with 7 series of monocotyledons, including Glumaceae, but did not use Lindley's terms for these. However, they did place the Liliaceous and Amaryllidaceous genera into separate series. The Liliaceae were placed in series Coronariae, while the Amaryllidaceae were placed in series Epigenae. The Liliaceae now consisted of 20 tribes, including Tulipae, Ciliae and Aspergi, and the Amaryllidaceae of 5, including Agaviae and Alstroemerae. An important addition to the treatment of the Liliaceae was the recognition of Aliae as a distinct tribe that would eventually find its way to the Aspergales as the Aliaoideae subfamily of the Amaryllidaceae. The appearance of Charles Darwin's Origin of Species in 1859 changed the way that taxonomists considered plant classification, incorporating evolutionary information into their schemata. The Darwinian approach led to the concept of phylogeny, tree-like structure, in assembling classification systems, starting with Aicolor. Having established a hierarchical system in which the flowering plants, angiosperms, were divided into monocotyledons and dicotyledons, further divided into 4 Marinto 7 orders. Within the Liliiflorae were 7 families, including Liliaceae and Amaryllidaceae. Liliaceae included Allium and Ornithogalum, modern Aliaoideae, and Asparagus. Engler, in his system, developed Aicolor's ideas into a much more elaborate scheme, which he treated in a number of works, including Die Natur Lichen Pflanzen Familien, Engler und Prandtl 1888, and Syllabus der Pflanzen Familien, 1892-1924. In his treatment of Liliiflorae, the Liliinae were a suborder which included both Liliaceae and Amaryllidaceae families. The Liliaceae had 8 subfamilies and the Amaryllidaceae 4. In this rearrangement of Liliaceae, with fewer subdivisions, the core Liliales were represented as subfamily Lilioideae, with Tulipae and Ciliae as tribes, the Asparagi were represented as Asparagoideae, and the Aliaoideae was preserved, representing the Aliaceous genera. Aliae, Agapanthiae and Chiliaceae were the 3 tribes within this subfamily. In the Amaryllidaceae, there was little change from Bentham and Hooker. A similar approach was adopted by Wettstein. In the 20th century, the Wettstein system, 1901-1935, placed many of the taxa in an order called Liliiflorae. Next, Johannes Paulus Lotze, 1911, proposed dividing the Liliiflorae into a number of smaller families, including Asparagaceae. Then Herbert Huber, 1969-1977, following Lotze's example, proposed that the Liliiflorae be split into 4 groups, including the Sparagoid Liliiflorae. The widely used Cronquist system, 1968-1988, used the very broadly defined order Liliales. These various proposals to separate small groups of genera into more homogeneous families made little impact till that of Dahlgren, 1985, incorporating new information including synapomorphy. Dahlgren developed Huber's ideas further and popularized them, with a major deconstruction of existing families into smaller units. They created a new order, calling it Aspergales. This was one of 5 orders within the superorder Liliiflorae. Where Cronquist saw 1 family, Dahlgren saw 40 distributed over 3 orders, predominantly Liliales and Aspergales. Over the 1980s, in the context of a more general review of the classification of angiosperms, the Liliaceae were subjected to more intense scrutiny. By the end of that decade, the Royal Botanic Gardens at Kew, the British Museum of Natural History and the Edinburgh Botanical Gardens formed a committee to examine the possibility of separating the family, at least for the organization of their herbaria. That committee finally recommended that 24 new families be created in the place of the original broad Liliaceae, largely by elevating subfamilies to the rank of separate families. The order Asparagales as currently circumscribed has only recently been recognized in classification systems. Through the advent of phylogenetics, the 1990s saw considerable progress in plant phylogeny and phylogenetic theory, enabling a phylogenetic tree to be constructed for all of the flowering plants. The establishment of major nucleides necessitated a departure from the older but widely used classifications such as Cronquist and Thorne, based largely on morphology rather than genetic data. This complicated discussion about plant evolution and necessitated a major restructuring. RBCL gene sequencing and cladistic analysis of monocots had redefined lily cells in 1995. From four morphological orders since Dahlgren. The largest clade representing the Liliaceae, all previously included in lily cells, but including both the Calochortaceae and Liliaceae sensu timora. This redefined family, that became referred to as core lily cells, but corresponded to the emerging circumscription of the Angiosperm phylogeny group, 1998. The 2009 revision of the Angiosperm phylogeny group system, APG3, places the order in the clade monocots. From the Dahlgren system of 1985 onwards, studies based mainly on morphology had identified the Asparagales as a distinct group, but had also included groups now located in Liliales, Pandanales, and Zingiberales. Research in the 21st century has supported the monophyly of Asparagales, based on morphology, 18S retina, and other DNA sequences, although some phylogenetic reconstructions based on molecular data have suggested that Asparagales may be paraphyletic, with Orchidaceae separated from the rest. Within the monocots, Asparagales is the sister group of the Camelinid clade. This cladogram shows the placement of Asparagales within the orders of Liliinae sensu chase and reveal, monocots, based on molecular phylogenetic evidence. The lilioid monocot orders are bracketed, namely Petrosaviales, Dioscoriales, Pandanales, Liliales, and Asparagales. These constitute a paraphyletic assemblage, that is groups with a common ancestor that do not include all direct descendants, in this case Camelinids as the sister group to Asparagales. To form a clade, all the groups joined by thick lines would need to be included. While Acorales and Alismatales have been collectively referred to as alismatid monocots, basal or early branching monocots, the remaining clades, lilioid and camelinid monocots, have been referred to as the core monocots. The relationship between the orders, with the exception of two sister orders, is pectinate, that is diverging in succession from the line that leads to the camelinids. Numbers indicate crown group, most recent common ancestor of sampled species of the clade of interest, divergence times in Maya, million years ago. A phylogenetic tree for the Asparagales, generally to family level, but including groups which were recently and widely treated as families but which are now reduced to subfamily rank, is shown below. The tree shown above can be divided into a basal paraphyletic group, the lower Asparagales, Asparagoids, from Orchidaceae to Asphodelaceae, and a well-supported monophyletic group of core Asparagales, higher Asparagoids, comprising the two largest families, Amaryllidaceae sensu lato and Asparagaceae sensu lato. Two differences between these two groups, although with exceptions, are the mode of microsporogenesis and the position of the ovary. The lower Asparagales typically have simultaneous microsporogenesis, i.e. cell walls develop only after both meiotic divisions, which appears to be an apomorphy within the monocots, whereas the core Asparagales have reverted to successive microsporogenesis, i.e. cell walls develop after each division. The lower Asparagales typically have an inferior ovary, whereas the core Asparagales have reverted to a superior ovary. A 2002 morphological study by Rudel treated possessing an inferior ovary as a synapomorphy of the Asparagales, stating that reversions to a superior ovary in the core Asparagales could be associated with the presence of nectaries below the ovaries. However, Stevens notes that superior ovaries are distributed among the lower Asparagales in such a way that it is not clear where to place the evolution of different ovary morphologies. The position of the ovary seems a much more flexible character, here and in other angiosperms, than previously thought. The APG3 system, when it was published in 2009, greatly expanded the families Xanthoriaceae, Amaryllidaceae, and Asparagaceae. 13 of the families of the earlier APG2 system were thereby reduced to subfamilies within these three families. The expanded Xanthoriaceae is now called Asphodelaceae. The APG2 families, left, and their equivalent APG3 subfamilies, right, are as follows. Orchidaceae is the largest family of all angiosperms and hence by far the largest in the order. The Dahlgren system recognized three families of orchids, but DNA sequence analysis later showed that these families are polyphyletic and so should be combined. Several studies suggest, with high bootstrap support, that Orchidaceae is the sister of the rest of asparagales. Other studies have placed the orchids differently in the phylogenetic tree, generally among the Boreaceae Hypoxidaceae clade. The position of Orchidaceae shown above seems the best current hypothesis, but cannot be taken as confirmed. Orchids have simultaneous microsporogenesis and inferior ovaries, two characters that are typical of the lower asparagales. However, their nectaries are rarely in the septa of the ovaries, and most orchids have dust-like seeds, atypical of the rest of the order. Some members of Vanilloideae and Cypripediaoideae have crustose seeds, probably associated with dispersal by birds and mammals that are attracted by fermenting fleshy fruit releasing fragrant compounds, for example vanilla. In terms of the number of species, Orchidaceae diversification is remarkable. However, although the other asparagales may be less rich in species, they are more variable morphologically, including tree-like forms. The four families excluding Boreaceae form a well-supported clade in studies based on DNA sequence analysis. All four contain relatively few species, and it has been suggested that they be combined into one family under the name Hypoxidaceae sensu lato. The relationship between Boreaceae, which includes only two genera, Borea and Alania, and other asparagales has remained unclear for a long time. The Boreaceae are mycorrhizal, but not in the same way as orchids. Morphological studies have suggested a clausal relationship between Boreaceae and Blandfordiaceae. There is relatively low support for the position of Boreaceae in the tree shown above. The relationship shown between Ixchelyriaceae and Tecotheliaceae is still unclear. Some studies have supported a clade of these two families, others have not. The position of Dorianthaceae has also varied, with support for the position shown above, but also support for other positions. The clade from Iridaceae upwards appears to have stronger support. All have some genetic characteristics in common, having lost Arabidopsis-type telomeres. Iridaceae is distinctive among the asparagales in the unique structure of the inflorescence, a rhipidium, the combination of an inferior ovary and three stamens, and the common occurrence of unifacial leaves, whereas bifacial leaves are the norm in other asparagales. Members of the clade from Iridaceae upwards have infralocular septal nectaries, which Riedel interpreted as a driver towards secondarily superior ovaries. The next node in the tree, Xanthoriaceae sensu lato plus the core asparagales, has strong support. Anomalous secondary thickening occurs among this clade, for example in Xanthoria, family Asphodelaceae, and Dracaena, family Asparagaceae sensu lato, with species reaching tree-like proportions. The core asparagales, comprising Amaryllidaceae sensu lato and Asparagaceae sensu lato, are a strongly supported clade, as are clades for each of the families. Relationships within these broadly defined families appear less clear, particularly within the Asparagaceae sensu lato. Stevens notes that most of its subfamilies are difficult to recognize, and that significantly different divisions have been used in the past, so that the use of a broadly defined family to refer to the entire clade is justified. Thus the relationships among subfamilies shown above, based on A.P. Webb, is somewhat uncertain. Several studies have attempted to date the evolution of the asparagales, based on phylogenetic evidence. Earlier studies generally give younger dates than more recent studies, which have been preferred in the table below. A 2009 study suggests that the asparagales have the highest diversification rate in the monocots, about the same as the order poles, although in both orders the rate is little over half that of the eudicot order Lamiales, the clade with the highest rate. The taxonomic diversity of the monocotyledons is described in detail by Kubitsky. Up-to-date information on the asparagales can be found on the Angiosperm Phylogeny website. The APG3 system's family circumscriptions are being used as the basis of the Kew-hosted World Checklist of Selected Plant Families. With this circumscription, the order consists of 14 families, Dahlgren had 31, with approximately 1,120 genera and 26,000 species. Order asparagales. The earlier 2003 version, APG2, allowed bracketed families, i.e. families which could either be segregated from more comprehensive families or could be included in them. These are the families given under including in the list above. APG3 does not allow bracketed families, requiring the use of the more comprehensive family, otherwise the circumscription of the asparagales is unchanged. A separate paper accompanying the publication of the 2009 APG3 system provided subfamilies to accommodate the families which were discontinued. The first APG system of 1998 contained some extra families, included in square brackets in the list above. Two older systems which use the order asparagales are the Dahlgren system and the Kubitsky system. The families included in the circumscriptions of the order in these two systems are shown in the first and second columns of the table below. The equivalent family in the modern APG3 system, see below, is shown in the third column. Note that although these systems may use the same name for a family, the genera which it includes may be different, so the equivalence between systems is only approximate in some cases. The asparagales include many important crop plants and ornamental plants. Crops include allium, asparagus, and vanilla, while ornamentals include irises, hyacinths, and orchids. Thanks for watching. Don't forget like the video and don't forget to subscribe.